All right, Shalom, Shalom, Shalom. I want to give all praises to our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, through His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shah, man. Peace and blessings to you, beloveds, in the new covenant, and to the 12 tribes scattered abroad, in the spirit of Yahweh Shah, man. And today, we're going to be talking about, you know, the importance of being treated like royalty, man, in the spirit. You know, whether you get it from your mother, your shawty, aka your wife or your queen, man. And doing this in the spirit and in the commandments. Now, this is going to be, you know, raw and transparent. So basically, I came back to Houston for my vacation. And you know what I'm saying? They were celebrating Nimrod and all that. You know, we keep the holy days, or we try to. But man, I got two witnesses, bro. My mama, you know, I had my aunt meet my mother, bro. And you know, they were just telling my mama how good I am, and you know, how solid I am and everything. And to my surprise, my mama was actually breaking bread with the Akim for like 30 to 40 minutes, man. And we started talking about Jacob and Rebecca. And my mom was like, she said, Rebecca was a good woman. She was a good woman. And that shows you, man, that a lot of you Israelites, you gotta pay attention. Because, man, I came in here and I know a lot of beloved ones, they didn't have mothers like that. So this is not to look down on y'all. Nothing crazy like that. This is just for a testimony. Now, I walked in, I think Saturday or Sunday, man. And my mama, man, she done put on some R&B. You know what I'm saying? She done had a beloved. You know what I'm saying? I had to soak in some Epsom salt and a bubble bath, man. But she was really trying to get me to relax and calm down. Then I was on the phone with one of my Akim, and my mom started rubbing my beard, talking about I gotta do something with it. Then, you know, my mama, like Jacob and Rebecca, man, she's always nurturing me, man. But she was talking about doing my hair, twisting up my hair and everything. So it was just a beautiful thing. And, man, she was talking about, you know, you need to go to the church, get you a like-minded woman, a godly wife and everything. She was telling a beloved, you know what I'm saying, to come home. She been begging me to come home to the H, man. And I've been wanting to. I've been trying to get some stuff together, man. Even my stepmom was nurturing the other day, bro. It's like, damn, beloved. But when I see how they act around most of these minions in the world, man, there's a lot of women, bro. She is very choosy, bro. Like, she don't give them no type of nurturing, no type of attention or nothing. It's almost like they have intuition. Now, they do have intuition. Then, what was so beautiful about it, she gave me two precious presents, bro. My great-grandmother, she actually passed away my senior year in college, man, and I actually cried, bro, but she gave me a precious gift because she knew I wasn't able to make it to the funeral, so she decided to, you know, frame it and leave it to the side for me because she knew how close me and my grandmother was and everything. So, like, you can't replace that motherly, that Rebecca, Jacob love, man. And I know a lot of brothers didn't have that. And y'all got to remember, a lot of brothers and sisters were raised on survival, man. But I think like Monday, I walk into my little brother's room, and she played Toni Braxton. I love me some him, and she started playing because I told her that the song reminded me of her. So she turned the song on, and instead of saying I love me some him, my own mama was like, I love me some Caleb. You know what I'm saying? So that vibration carried over into the truth. It carried over into my life and everything. And like you already know, I went to the Thotties, to Danielle, to Priscilla, Miracle, Ashley. Who I'm missing, bro? Y'all already know. I got a whole, Alma, Amber, got a whole ton of stories, man. But most of them is wholesome. And this type of experience, bro, I believe it confirms my life. But I'm going to go into the scriptures with y'all. Y'all got to look at Josiah and Jehosheba. You got to look at Moses when he was nurtured by the Midianite women. Look at John the Baptist and his mama, Yahushua and Mary. You know what I'm saying? Then, you know what I'm saying? What the hell? But then, bro, just making sure Beloved was just like comforted, man. Just feeding me everything. Making sure I had something to eat. Making sure I had money, bro. Just spoiling the Beloved, but spoiling in a good way. And my aunt Raheem told my mama about how a lot of brothers, mainly the men, be, you know, jealous and everything. And my pops actually told me since I was, when I was growing up, he already told me that they were jealous back then because I wasn't like all the other dudes and everything. So going forward, y'all, I'm not focusing on debate and the tit for tat. It's really time to edify. And while I'm getting myself together and staying in the spirit of Yahushua, I know I'm gonna run into some things, man, but it's a beautiful thing. But yeah, I'm getting back in the spirit of edifying. I don't know what to bring out. I don't want to force the how to be a daughter of Yahweh videos, man. And then Beloved ones, they want to start a podcast of the shoddy vibes and everything. And just talk about positiveness and love, bro. And just using it as an example and being an example in the new covenant. But being treated like royalty is a must because it makes me want to protect it even more. And I'm going to be like that towards my future rib. If you're Yahushua, stay the same, man. So, with that being said, y'all Beloveds be easy. And peace and blessings. And shalom. And Salaki, let me say this too. She also made a mention that I was the missing piece. She felt like I was the missing piece to the family. And she said that ever since I came back home, she said that she feels like herself. And she said that she feels balanced. And I told my mama, I was like, yeah, when I was when I was at Sonic, I said my manager, she told me that most likely I make the women feel protected. And then even when Alma, when she cried in front of me and she was talking about, you know what I'm saying, daddy issues and everything, which is always something that I feel like Yahweh Shah probably already gave me. Or he did already give me. Even my big sister, she been wanting me to come home. My little sister, we ain't talked in forever, but my family, like, you know, she want to see you and everything. So just hearing her say and hearing her cry on the phone, just hearing her tell me that I make her feel at peace, man, that's a sign of royalty in the spirit of Yahweh Shah, you know, going through the battles, going through, you know, life and death and really fighting and earning what I have now, you know, holding my integrity. On top of that, while being an example, you know what I mean? Taking down the toughest spiritual foes through Yahweh Shah. So that's what makes you royalty in the spirit, man. Not all this carnal nonsense. And, you know, I take that and I take it honorably. And that's why, you know, all those other dudes, man, that's very, yeah. Huh? Are you finna get some?
Yeah.
But that's why, like, excuse me, let me slide through. But that's why those other dudes talking about how they would tag up the houses and just do mischievous stuff, bro. Like, I was never that type of kid, man. It was crazy. Like, a lot of them had, you know, two parent households and all that, bro. But real talk, man, like, a lot of brothers, y'all want brothers to not feel like royalty or whatever. Because of, for whatever reason, man. But it comes to a point in time where you start getting tired of that bitter energy, man. Like, honestly. And stop using that to discourage the argument, arguments in the faith, bro. Because there's a lot of sisters who want to get edified, but a lot of y'all still haven't. Y'all don't understand. You can't teach the weaker vessels the same way you do a man. And I've been saying that. And so, being with my mama, being treated like royalty, you know, she wasn't rubbing my feet or nothing like that, but, you know, rubbing my scalp and just making sure I was just comforted, bro. I use that because Yahweh said, honor thy father and thy mother, man. A lot of you dudes, you know, y'all forget that commandment. You know what I'm saying? So if your mother is wicked, if your father's wicked, you got to learn. We have to learn how to create our own paradise. You know what I mean? And a lot of guys, you know, be falling out the faith because, you know, some brothers and sisters, they may not fast and pray enough. You know what I'm saying? Or they're so used to false prophecy, not studying for themselves. That's a lot. It's a lot of factors that play into why, you know, brothers and sisters' mind don't be right. But I was gonna say this too before I left, man. When your mama, when she treats you like royalty, that's not a sign of weakness. And working around Gentiles and other nations and military type people, man, they always want to be, you know, they don't want to have no feelings. They want to be hard nosed, and those type of people are very close minded, but they're not intelligent. They're not none of that. They're not creative. And watch out for those type of people, because they'll try to make you feel like you're inadequate or whatever. But you always want to have a balance. You know what I'm saying? Don't be no punk, but, you know, avoid those type of people, because those type of people, they never experienced what I call shawty vibes. They never experienced that, so they don't know how to love a woman. They don't know how to really love a queen or vice versa. You feel me? But one thing about it, these people are not finna push me off my square. You know what I mean? So with that being said, like I said, that's that Jacob and Rebecca love, man. And I am not ready for the day she's passing away, even though she's in the world. And even my family, bro, that's just something that's just hard for everybody. So yeah, this time for real. With that being said, peace and blessings and shalom. And stay pushing forward, stay inspired, man. And enjoy yourself. And peace and love, man. Shalom.